And what's actually is something that's becoming more prevalent, becoming more out in the open, becoming more revealed. And that is what it is. There's a warfare. The enemy is coming. Now I just want to say this right here. The enemy is coming to many, as the scripture says, the thief comes to kill, steal, and destroy, but he comes as an angel of light. He's able to transform. And one of the most dangerous things that a person can use is emotions as a weapon. When a person is able to use their emotions as a weapon to control, to get them to believe in, to direct, to teach, also to indoctrinate, then that's a weapon. And what's one of the things what popped in my spirit was, as I was driving, God reminded me of when I was a kid. And when I was a kid, we was poor. We was poor, of course. And what happened is, like, there was times when you would turn out the lights, but then when you go back, you go back into the kitchen or somewhere, and when you pop the lights on, what happens, there'll be a whole lot of roaches that begin to scatter. A whole lot of roaches begin to scatter. And so, and what God was letting me know that, and see what it was, the light that I turned on that caused what was playing in the dark to begin to disperse. And this is what God is showing me, is he's shining his light. In many of your situations, God is shining his light, and he's going to shine his light in certain dark areas. And in those areas, when those, when he shines his light, when he exposes, when he uncovers those dark things, many things in your life is going to begin to scatter that wasn't there. You're going to be surprised. You're going to be surprised at who you thought was your friend, but then you're going to discover that they were just on assignment. They were a spy. They were a mole, and they were there to learn everything about you, learn your ways, learn your desires, learn your weaknesses. That's what this demon, and this is what the plot of the enemy is, to learn your weaknesses. And so it's like a spy, an agent, doing certain things, reporting back certain informations, reporting back certain ways, certain conversations. This is what's happening to many of you. The enemy is trying to, or has been, while you're tapping your conversation, while you're tapping your every move, and reporting it back. And see the enemy knows your every move and knows your every step. And so what the enemy does, seeing that he knows your behavior, he knows how to get you upset. He knows how to make you happy. He knows how to make you sad. And see what the enemy is doing, he's experimenting with your behavior. That's what he's doing. He's putting certain things in your life to see how you're gonna respond and watch it. And he's taking survey, he's writing certain things down about your behavior, about your lifestyle. And so all I'm doing is I just wanted to make you aware of that you're being watched. You are being watched, my brother, and you are being watched, my sister. And so in that you being watched, as the scripture says, you watch as well as pray. So I keep your eyes open, not just naturally open, but spiritually open. And don't just trust anything. The scripture says, cursed be the man that trusts in man and make flesh his own. Do not make nothing tangible. Do not make nothing fleshly your arm, your strength. And like I said, what the enemy is using, he's using emotions, fake emotions. He's using emotions to control what you do. This spirit's going to use emotions to indoctrinate, to get you to believe in certain things, to believe in certain words, to believe in certain things. And see, so just be careful, because he's a great deceiver. And everything that glitters not gold. That's why God tells us that we need the gift of discerning of spirits. That means to know the difference between what's of God and what's not of God. And see, because as the scripture says, the enemy does come, and he will come as an angel of light. See, he can camouflage. He can also become a chameleon. anything that he touched, he can become it. And so this is his game. One of the also the definitions of a hypocrite or someone who's fake or phony is an actor or an actress. And the actor and the actresses that's able to perform the best are considered very good. And also those are the stars. And so those are the categories where these agents perform, and they're on stage. And all of these agents have different levels. It's called scripture said we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against spiritual wickedness, against rulers of darkness in high places. But God tells us to put on the whole armor of God. And the purpose, that way, we will be able to withstand against the wiles, the devices, the tools, and the tactics of the enemy. So this is why it's so important to hear. Don't reject. That's why we've been talking about how God said his people perish for the lack of knowledge. Knowledge is information. Just like a computer. When you turn that computer on and when you put that password in, that's information. And that information gives you access into that website. And just like when you eat, or if you're hungry. And see, when you're hungry, your body is starving for food, starving for something. They're starving for information. And then so when you begin to eat, you're giving your body information, just like if you're thirsty. When you are thirsty, you're thirsting for information. You're thirsting something that's going to satisfy, something that's going to answer, something that's going to fulfill. And the moment you begin to drink, then your information, you get that information. And that information will become downloaded. The same thing with the enemy. Information. God's people perish for the lack of it. The information to be informed, to be aware. God is speaking. That's why it says people perish because they reject. Don't reject information, God's information. Don't reject the wisdom. Don't reject wise counsel. Don't reject, God says, the Bible said, that they hear my voice, harden not your heart, because in the last days there's a spiritual blindness. There is a spiritual blinding that's been released, or that has been released in the land. And what's happening, there's many doctrines that are being taught. And one of them, which is the doctrine of devils. And the doctrine of devils are being downloaded into many who claim to be of God. But the scripture says, you'll know a tree by the fruit it bear. And Jesus also said, not that you would bear much fruit, but also that your fruit remain. And so God is watching it. And see, the thing about it, don't get upset. Don't get upset when things don't change. Don't get upset. Because your job is just to plant. Your job is just to one water, one plant. But it's God that gives the increase. Your job is just to be obedient and just do what God has called you. Don't worry about no one else. Just focus on what God has put in your heart. Because if you focus on what God has put in your heart, he is going to take care of your heart's desires, things you need. Just like with Elijah. When Elijah shut up heaven when he told the king there would be no rain. And as he spoke those words, God spoke to him and told him to go down to this house where his widow was at. Go down there, she's going to slay you. Then after that, God told him to go down to this brook. And I commanded some ravens to take care of you. And so when you do God's will and when you do what God says, he's going to command things to come through. He's going to command blessings to come through. He's going to command your answer. Whatever you need, he said he's the supply to all of your need. And so in that need that you have, God is going to command your supply to come to your need for such a time as this. Is all right? God bless you. Good morning.